Aircraft landing distance starts from 50 feet above threshold to the aircraft fully stops on the runway. Or in other words, I can say landing distance should not exceed the landing distance available. That means whatever the runway is there, the aircraft should able to land within the runway. Now the requirement of landing distance, which is set by the regulatory authority, says that the operator must ensure that the landing mass of an aeroplane allow full stop from 50 feet above threshold within 60% for turbo jet engines and 70% for turboprop engines. Now for an example, turboprop aeroplane has a calculated landing distance of 693 meters. Then what is the minimum landing distance shall must be available at the airfield in order to comply with the regulations, saying that 693 meters is 70% of how much runway length. So 693 multiplying by 1.43 would give you a value of 991 meters. That means if the runway is 991 meters long, the aeroplane is landing within the 70% of the runway available, which is 991 meters runway available, and landing distance required is 693 meters for turboprop engine, which is 70% of 991 meters. Then what is 1.43 then? If we multiply 70% with 1.43, the value is 100. So 1.43 is the factor used to find the relevant runway length. Calculate the relevant runway length for turbojet engine, we use 1.67 as the factor, because as per the regulatory authority, the turbojet engine should stop within 60% of the runway. If we multiply 60% with 1.67, the value is 100. Now solving the question other way around, saying that the available landing distance is 2015 meters, then what must be the landing distance for turboprop engine in order to comply with the regulation? The regulation says 70% for the turboprop engine. We need to find 70% of 2015 meters. So 2015 meters divided by 1.43 would give you 1409 meters. That means the turboprop must come to full stop by 1409 meters. Considering the other factors in calculating the landing distance, saying that weather or the forecast indicates that the runway is contaminated or wet at the point of estimated time of arrival, then the landing distance must be at least 115% of the dry landing distance. Even the landing distance increases on a wet or contaminated runway by 15%, the aircraft must still be able to land within the 70% of the runway for turboprop engine and 60% for turbojet engine. Considering an example, if a dry landing distance for turbojet engine is 920 meters, what would be the minimum landing distance shall be available if the runway was wet? So the dry landing distance must be increased by 15% to get the wet landing distance. Now multiplying 920 meters, which is the dry landing distance, into 1.15, which is the wet factor, would give you wet landing distance, which is 1058 meters, which is the minimum landing distance required on a wet runway. Now the landing distance required, which is 1058, must be within the 60% of the landing distance available. Minimum length of runway required, which is 1058 on wet runway, multiplied by 1.67, which is the turbojet engine calculation factor, gives you 1767 meters. That means if the runway is wet and the dry landing distance is 920 meters, the minimum length of landing distance required must be 1767 meters for turbojet engine. Combined wet factor for turbojet engine is 1.92 and for turboprop engine is 1.64. Just don't get confused with the factors used in the turboprop engines and the turbojet engines. While Wright Aviation is currently taking online lectures for CPL, ATPL and airline preparation, if you need to join, click on the link below in the description and fill the form, and Wright Aviation will get back to you ASAP. On the behalf of Wright Aviation, I am Captain Siddharth.